behavior going on. Seems whatever there was a bit of a tussle going on. Must be one young bird on the right hand side. Not tussling, sorry, it's not a youngster getting fed, it's a bit of a beak wrestle, I guess. Or a hornbill wrestle.
That's nice,
yeah. Imagine that's his, imagine yourself on the scale of those birds, or on the same scale. Very large, very powerful beaks, very sharp beaks. Imagine as much as it's just maybe a semi-friendly competition between the two. You don't want to mistime your attack or your defense, because you could quite easily damage an eye or something. So it's quite a bit of skill involved there. Never seen this before. This is my first time that I've seen this ever. Ooh, it looks nice, eh, James, with that shade behind. The shadow of the bird right on the edge of it. But obviously it's not that serious. I mean, otherwise they'd still be at it, so... It's more a sort of, let's see who's stronger and quicker. The berries that it's eating. Berries. Orange berries that it was eating was part of the solanum family. Is that of interest? Same family as poison apples and potatoes. I like how it puts the wing out there. Look at all the balancing going on. You know, we quite often look at animals and we just sort of assume that they just run around and jump around and do everything they do so easily, but we forget that all your animals, especially animals that live in a wild environment like this, they are very athletic. They are all very healthy. Unless you were an healthy, strong animal, you wouldn't survive to adulthood. And even if you did, you would never get the opportunity to breed. So genetically, the animals out here are very, very strong. When you see them moving around like they were just now, you look at the balance and how they use their tails and their wings and their beaks. When you look at impala running or any of the animals doing what they do, it's quite impressive actually. Excuse me. Alright, well I think let's slowly mosey on. Afternoon out here. Like I said, we're back at this waterhole later on. I'll be coming see some of those baboons if they hang around here. Yeah, let us know please, and then also hopefully if the afternoon goes well we might see a leopard again. Yeah, I was sitting on that sort of broken branch. Where's it gone? Still see it. Oh, there it is, yeah. In the shade there a little bit. Called a crested barbet. And the way it's sitting with that beak that open, it shows you that this bird is a little bit warm. Back, a lot of gravity on our side here. Got him? Oh, there he goes. Beautiful tree as well. Love this tree. It's one of those trees that just looks like it should have a leopard in one of the branches.
Quite a bit of mud on, like he's like rubbing his things.
Yeah, from the ellies. Yeah. Especially at the moment, it's bearing fruit, so they're eating a lot of marulas on it. You might as well have a little rub up while you're doing it. Up.
Oh,